Thank you. Hey guys, today is the 22nd of October 2023. Gingerman Raceway in Michigan, the very last race of the season. Just did three 20 minute sessions, and I gotta tell ya, I did enough. I can do one more, but no thanks. Car is actually doing good. Last time I was here was 3 years ago, and we had that issue with the left driver's side oil catch can overflowing. And now it's good. We're gonna touch on that subject a little later. I wanna show you exactly what I've done to tackle that problem. Was running the Falcon 660s tires. They did pretty good. They do need to be warmed up. It was slippery as hell in the morning of the first session. 45 degrees outside, cold. Right now it's 50, it's okay. Obviously you gotta do a few laps to warm them up, but they do okay. Running E85, pretty good. Did a 141.7. Advanced group is running right now. I was gonna show you some cars how they run, but they built this new fence and I can't get too close, so I'm gonna be watching through a fence. It sucks, can't see. Shite. It's actually pretty getting cold, man. This is us, by the way. Got a Supra. 07 STI. 05 STI. 16 SS. And my 06. Then we got a Miata. And a Mustang.
Thank you.
I'm really going. Hey guys, back at base. I don't even know. It's almost 9 p.m. Took way too long to unpack. Car did good. I do have a check engine light though for an O2 sensor. Before the cat, you know. I'm not gonna talk about it. So this is what you get. Look at these tires. Still, you know, these have 4 autocrosses and 1 track day. Still plenty of meat left. Falcon 660s. Look at these pieces of rubber. There's just like stuck patches of rubber, like bubbles kind of stuck to the tires, if you can find one. Did not rotate tires. Look at this. I did change this to a 3-inch axle back because the last 2.5-inch axle back had some kind of a rattle going on inside this pipe. I tried fixing it. I actually cut open the muffler because I thought it was in the muffler, but it wasn't. Ended up inside this, couldn't fix it. So this one is a tiny bit closer to the bumper. And as you can see, there's actually an actual hole right in there. So I'm gonna cut this off and maybe get one of these ugly pieces that protect the bumper, and or maybe just try and fix that and low. Probably I'm gonna probably try and fix this and lower this muffler. I don't like the look of that thing. Check this out. I actually saw, as I was going, I don't know, over 100, a piece of rubber from a car in front of me hit, you know, flying towards me and hit here, and the windshield right over here. All right, let's talk about the PCV system, which in my case are 3 oil catch cans. So before, as some of you may remember, this catch can was connected to this cylinder head. This is actually the same. This just goes around here and down to the block. And then this catch can, a line was just here, ran towards into that cylinder head, right? But I had an issue with oil actually overflowing at the same track out of this thing, okay? Just this one. Just the left one, driver's side. And I did an IAG competition oil pen. Didn't work because even in an autocross, I did collect probably about this much oil throughout the day, which on a track day, it would overflow for sure. So the IAG, I'm sure it's working, it's doing its thing. It's, I'm sure it's helping, you know, but it's not, didn't fix this problem. So what I've done was I basically connected this cylinder head. Where is this hose? This guy here goes down, connects to this cylinder head, and goes here to this oil catch can. And this cylinder head, this is the hose right here. This guy here goes to this oil catch can. So the idea here is, as I'm making a right turn, the oil doesn't have anywhere to go. It's trying to come out here out of this cylinder head, but it would have to travel all the way up this hose to make to that catch can. But gravity is against it, and it works. So I'm going to actually now check how much oil I collected after 2 sessions, because I did check after the first session naturally, and I had maybe this much after 20 minutes or whatever it was. So I'm gonna check right now. Just gotta remove this cover. No idea how much is in there. Check it out. This is it. There's maybe, I don't know, this much in there. Almost nothing. Success. So I was actually thinking of getting this kind of a one-way valve system. I think IA or Cusco makes it. It's for $300. And basically what it does is there's a one-way valve that goes left and right as you turn, and it blocks the oil. Guess how much these cost me? I don't know, $5. That was it, the lines, the hoses. All right, guys. I'm about to faint. I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.